Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel English Guru for All. Dear students, in this video, I'll explain the poem Stay Calm written by Grenville Kleiser. Students, the title is Stay Calm. You need to interpret the title first so you can guess something about the title. Now, what is the meaning of stay? Stay means remain. And what is the meaning of calm? Calm means quiet or peaceful or tranquil. So the poet is telling us you must stay calm or you must remain quiet or peaceful or tranquil. Now, what are the reasons behind this one? So we are going to see certain context or certain situations in which Grenville Kleiser is trying to tell us we must stay calm. And this is a didactic poem. This is also optimistic in nature, so we need to understand this one. And one picture is given over here. By observing the picture, you can understand it shows that you must stay calm. Before starting this poem, I'll explain or I'll tell you something about the author. This is the part of the introduction. Now, what is given there? Who is the author of this particular poem? Grenville Kleiser. Means the name of the poet is Grenville Kleiser. And he was born in 1868 and died in 1935. He was born in Toronto, Ontario, Canada. He was a North American author. He was the author of inspirational books and guides regarding oratorical success and personality. This is very important part over here. He wrote what? Inspirational books as well as guides regarding what? Some kind of guidance, you can say, regarding oratorical. What is the meaning of this word that is given in the bracket? Relating to the art or practice of public speaking. So he was famous for this one. Even he worked as an instructor in public speaking at L Divinity School, L University. And one most important thing is given here. During the Great Depression, what is the meaning of Great Depression? A long and severe recession in an economy or market. That is called Great Depression of 1930s, and he sent out checks for $1 each enclosed with a note reading to aid business. So here you can understand he is so much optimistic with the help of this particular point. So this is the basic information related to the poet Grenville Kleiser. This is very important, you must know, because we are going to discuss about his poem and the title of the poem is Stay Calm. Now let us discuss about the poem. So this is just the introduction also. We are going to discuss this poem in detail. Now what is given about the poem here? The poet counsels the readers to keep calm in the face of many big and small upsets of life. This is very important part. So the poet is counseling to whom? The readers. So right now we are the readers of this poem, and he's telling us you must keep calm, you must stay calm, you must be peaceful, you must keep yourself cool also, you can say. And because of what? To face in the face of many big and small upsets of life. So there may be certain struggles, you can say frustrations, there may be certain problems, obstacles, hindrances in our life. And in all these worst situations of life, we must keep ourselves calm or we must remain peaceful or tranquil. Now, there are certain advantages of being calm or quiet. What are the different advantages? I'll explain when I'll discuss the poem. Now, what is the second point here? It states that a tranquil temperament. What is the meaning of temperament? Temperament means nature. So tranquil means what? A peaceful nature is very important. Peaceful nature is the most potent weapon one can have against adversity. So in any kind of adversity, in any kind of tension, you can say, in any kind of problems, frustrations, which is the strongest weapon? And that is nothing but tranquil temperament. You must remain what? Calm or quiet. So this is nothing but the central idea. So So while discussing the poem, this must be in your mind. What is the main aim of the poet behind writing something or behind telling, behind, you can say, behind the message of this particular poem. Now let us discuss about the poem, what is given there. Now this is the text of the poem. What is the poem? Here the poem is given on the screen. I'll read the poem first and I'll explain each and every stanza. Line by line discussion will be there. So how many stanzas there? Three stanzas are there. And each stanza contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Total 8 lines are there in each stanza. Now when you feel like saying something that you know you will regret, or keenly feel an insult, not quite easy to forget, that is the time to curb resentment and maintain a mental peace. For when your mind is tranquil, all your ill thoughts simply cease. It is easy to be angry when defrauded or defied, to be peeved and disappointed if your wishes are denied, but to win a worthwhile battle over selfishness and spite, you must learn to keep strict silence though you know you are in the right. So keep your mental balance when confronted by a foe, be it enemy in ambush or some danger that you know. If you are poised and tranquil when all around is strife, be assured that you have mastered the most vital thing in life. And what is that most important thing in life? That is staying calm. Dear students, this is very simple poem. One by one we are going to discuss over here. I mean to say stanza or line by line discussion will be done here. Now let us start with the first stanza. Now what is here? What is the first stanza? I'll read it again and I'm going to tell you the important words over here. Stanza first, when you feel like saying something. Deliberately I made this one in italic. What is the reason behind this one? When you feel like saying something, if you want to say something that you know you will regret. What is the meaning of regret here? A regret is nothing but feel sad or disappointed over. If you feel sad that you know you will regret, if you feel sad or keenly feel an insult. What is the meaning of insult? That is abusing, offending or disrespectful. If you keenly means what? Minutely. Keenly means what? Minutely. Not quite easy to forget. You cannot forget that one. That is the time to curb. What is the meaning of curb over here? You need to control. Resentment means what? Meaning of resentment? Irritation. Feeling of unhappiness. And maintain a mental peace. For when your mind is tranquil, all your ill thoughts simply cease. Dear students, what is given here? The poet is telling us what are the different advantages of being or to stay calm in all the situations. If you are regretful, if you feel sad, if you feel what is something insulting and not easy to forget, you cannot forget that one. There can be so many situations in your life where you feel insulting and you cannot forget such situations, such scenarios. In that case, what is important there? This is nothing but the time to curb. You need to control your dissatisfaction. You need to control your feeling of dissatisfaction or irritation, that is resentment. And maintain a mental peace. There is alliteration now. Ma sound is there or M sound is there. Ma. So alliteration is there. I'll explain even literary devices in this poem. So when you need to maintain your mental peace, when you need to have mental peace, when you feel so much sad, when you feel something is insulting and you cannot forget, then you have to control your emotions. You have to control your feeling of unhappiness and you have to keep a mental peace. For when your mind is tranquil, so whenever your mind is tranquil means what? When your mind is so much peaceful, quiet, Then all the ill thoughts. What is the meaning of O here? Ill thoughts means what? Bad thoughts. Anything wrong. You cannot do that one if you are going to be calm. So this is the simple meaning of this first stanza. So certain situations are given. So two opposite things are given here. Regret, insult, and you need to forget that one. You need to forget this one. And what you need to do? You have to control your feeling of unhappiness. You need to maintain your mental peace. You need to keep your mind peaceful, and it will help. It will help for what? To avoid ill thoughts. So cease means what? You can stop such kind of bad emotions, bad feelings. So this is very important. And most of the time, what we do, we become so angry. So we are going to talk about anger also in the next stanza. So we must stay calm. The only message is given by the poet and this poem, and that is nothing but what are the advantages to stay calm in your life. Now, what is the next stanza? Second stanza. It is easy to be angry. It is easy to be angry. This word is very, very important. When defrauded or defied. What is the meaning of defrauded? Means what? Cheated. You are deceived. You are deceived. You are disobeyed. What is the meaning of defrauded? You are cheated by someone. You are deceived by someone. And what is the meaning of defied? You are insulted or disobeyed by someone. So it is very easy to be angry at people. You can be so much angry at people. But when you are deceived, if somebody is going to deceive you, definitely this is normal human tendency. But still the poet is saying that you must stay calm. You must remain yourself quiet or tranquil. To be peeved and disappointed. What is the meaning of peeved over here? To be annoyed. You feel that you must be so much angry now. And you are going to do something wrong. So there is some, and always you need to think about this. Whenever you are too much angry, do not take any decisions. This is, and in anger we are going to take what? Wrong decisions. If your wishes are denied, if people are not going to accept your wishes. Denied means what? They are not going to accept. They are rejected. But to win a worthwhile battle, if you want to win such kind of battle, if you want to, you can say, handle such kind of situations in your life, or selfishness and spite. What is the meaning of spite over here? Hatred. This is nothing but the feeling of hatred or jealousy. So dear students, this is very important to understand. This is very meaningful poem, meaningful stanza also. Already I discussed stanza number one, this is stanza number two. And the poet is telling us, defrauded, defied, peeved, disappointed, denied, then selfishness, spite, all these are the negative words. And if you want to avoid such kind of negativity, then you must learn to keep strict silence. Compulsory, you must keep silence in your life. Though you know you are in the right, yes, you know that you are right, still you are deceived, still you are insulted, still you are, or you feel to be annoyed, still you are disappointed, and you are rejected. To win that battle, you must keep yourself peaceful or you must be in tranquility. This is very important. So peace of mind is very important in all the situations. If you want to maintain your life healthy as well as carefree and tension free, then you must stay calm. And that is only the message which is given by the poet in this poem. Now the words are very important. You can see, to avoid the negativity of life, you must stay calm, or you must remain peaceful or tranquil. Now what is there? Third stanza is there. This is the last stanza. So keep your mental balance now. So keep your mental balance. This is very important. What is the mental balance? Mental peace. You have to keep your mental peace. When confronted by a foe. What is the meaning of confronted? Faced. When you are opposed. when you are opposed, when you are opposed by your foe. By your foe means what? What is the meaning of a foe? Foe means over here your enemy, your enemy. Then be it enemy in ambush. What is the meaning of ambush? Ambush means hiding place, trap. Let trap your enemy in ambush. So this is nothing but what? This is nothing but a trap for even your enemy, or some danger that you know some kind of danger is there. If you are poised and tranquil, if you are poised and tranquil, what is the meaning of poised? Means if you are balanced, if you are balanced, you need to control your mind in such a situations. And what is the meaning of tranquil? The meaning of tranquil is to be calm and peaceful. When all around is strife, what is the meaning of strife? Something wrong. Something wrong is happening all around. Something wrong is happening all around. What is important here? You must maintain, you must keep your mental balance. This is the most important thing. Be assured that you have mastered the most vital thing in life. And the poet is saying that, the poet is standing over here, the poet is saying that you need to assure that you are the master of what? To keep balance, or to keep mental balance in your life. So I request everyone, dear students, this is very important poem and very meaningful poem, and you need to understand why to do this one. What are the reasons behind to stay calm? And here, all to avoid all kind of negativity from your life, you need to stay calm. This is very, and you can apply this poem to different situations in your life. And with the help of three stanzas only, you can understand this is optimistic poem, this is didactic poem, and it shows us we must be so much peaceful in all the situations. We must keep our mind cool and calm in all the worst situations. Now what is the next one? Some important words are given here. Already I told you the meanings, but at least you must know what is the meaning of regret, sad. What is the meaning of curb? To check or restrain something. Resentment, continuous feeling of unhappiness. Tranquil, to be calm and peaceful. Cease means to stop. Defrauded means cheated or deceived. Defied means insulted or disobeyed. And pure means irritated or annoyed. Now some more words are there. Denied means rejected. Spite means what? Hatred or ill will. Confronted means faced or opposed. Foe means an opponent or an enemy. Then ambush means hiding place or trap. Poise means balanced. And strife means bitter or violent reaction. And vital means of the utmost importance. Students, this is the part of what it may help you to even develop or enrich your vocabulary. Now, theme or central idea of the poem. What is the theme of the poem? So human traits are discussed in the poem. Human traits means what? Human qualities. And these are positive as well as negative. Whenever there is a negativity, you must stay calm. That is only the thing you need to understand from this poem. So focuses on inner feeling of every human being. Yes, for every normal human being, all the things can be there. All these things can be there. You can consider two things over here, positivity and negativity. How to behave and give reaction to someone, and this is also discussed in the poem. How to behave, how to keep silence, how to maintain the mental balance, how to keep strict silence and in different situation, and how to react others. This is also important. The poem is didactic and optimistic in nature. The poet tells the advantages of being calm in any worst situation in our life. And this is applicable, this is universal. The application of this poem is universal. And every human being can apply to his or her situations in life. Now, literary devices. Two devices are discussed here. Prominent alliteration is there. The repetition of usually initial consonant sounds in two or more neighboring words. So that is called alliteration. And two examples are given here. So you can find out more examples in the poem. that is the time to curb resentment. So to sound is over there and that is repeated. This is consonant. And maintain a mental peace, and this is also italic, and this is M sound or ma sound. What is the second one? Enjambment. What is enjambment? That is the running over of a sentence from one verse or couplet into another so that closely related words fall in different lines. It means what? To understand the meaning of first line, you need to consider or you need to refer to the second line. It is easy to be angry. So to understand the meaning of this one, you have to refer to the next one, that is when defrauded or defied. There are more examples of enjambment, and you can find out more literary devices or figures of speech in this poem. So in this way, I explain the poem Stay Calm, written by Granville Kleiser. Dear students, this is very important poem, and this poem is prescribed in different universities for BCom, BSc or BA also, even in certain schools, also CBSE, then it may be state boards also. So I made this poem so simple to understand. Hope it will help you to understand the poem. And please apply all the things in your life and stay calm. Do not worry. If you understood the poem, please like and share the video or this poem, and subscribe the channel, and also please I request everyone to press the bell icon. Thank you. Thank you so much.